Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick coming to you from FEMA Region 4, Southeastern United States. I said that because I just want to make a quick video. I normally don't get into any political side of it. Brothers and sisters, there was a brother who's a sponsor of one of the orphans, and he lives in the Toronto area of Canada, and he had sent me a link, and I'll put the link below here. There's some kind of a cable news channel I've never heard of. It wasn't Russia Today, but it was another news channel. And they were talking, there was an American Marine veteran who was talking about the military-industrial complex and how, this is all about money, of course, and these wars. And he was going on and on about it and, you know, how it's an inside job and the CIA is the ones who created and trained Al-Qaeda, all these things, which are true, even though there are, you know, Muslim jihadists who do want to kill us, but they're funded and supported and trained. And really it's kind of a lot of inside stuff going on to foment out of chaos a new world order. That's their plan, written right on the back of the American dollar bill. Anyway, so this brother in Toronto is a pretty young guy. And, you know, a lot of people haven't heard all these things, and especially younger people are not that cynical, you know, they're more optimistic about things. And so this brother sent it to me and asked me if it was true and all that, and I was trying to tell him, yeah, it was. And I was messaging him on Facebook. And brothers and sisters, the guy who was in the news article was, you know, trying to blame, you know, making a big blame on Israel too. You know, Israel wants to make their country bigger and cover all the land that God promised Abraham, and that's, you know, one of the big reasons behind this. So I was just answering the guy, this brother, and I was writing in my message, I was saying that, you know, everything he's saying is true, but we shouldn't blame Israel. You know, because Israel's not the mastermind, it's actually the military-industrial complex, and actually it's what they call the Anglo-American Empire, you know, which is really Anglo being the Anglo-Saxons or the Great Britain. It's really the Great Britain. You know, the City of London is not the same as what you know as London. There's also something called the City of London, which is inside London. You know, just like the Vatican, the City of London, D.C., the District of Columbia is a whole separate entity than what people know. You know, if you look at these are legal technicalities that they use. So there's the City of London. Anyway, that's the financiers. The City of London, you know, is really the seat of this power of the money of the Illuminati that runs the world and all that kind of stuff. But I didn't get into all that. In my statement, I was saying, you know, don't blame Israel. It's really the British and the American CIA and the military-industrial complex who are doing this. And I said, have you ever heard of Alex Jones? And then I was going to put Infowars.com, but I put info, and then for some reason, I just put a space. I put info, and then I put a space just out of a habit. I put info, space, wars.com. So I had wars.com, info, space, wars.com. And then when I entered to do the message on Facebook, brothers and sisters, it came up in red and said, your comments have been blocked because you are about to communicate potentially dangerous information, you know, and you go back and correct your comment and then you can send it. And brothers and sisters, I corrected it. I went back and redid it and took out Israel and put the Infowars.com together. And then I sent the message and then it went through, but when I checked, that message was totally deleted. The whole thing was gone. Everything I said was totally removed and gone, brothers and sisters. And so, but now I went back and I just put InfoWars by itself and it went through. So I don't know if there was actually live monitoring of my comments or the article he sent me, this news video he sent me and all that triggered it. And then I used a combination of Israel and InfoWars or how it worked, what set it off. But I'm going to put a banner on this video of InfoWars censored on Facebook, and by the grace of God, you know, Alex Jones might pick this up. People need to know about this, brothers and sisters, how close we are to the New World Order, how close we are to the tribulation period spoken of in the Bible, the seven-year tribulation with the one world dictator and the mark of the beast, 666, and all those things. You know, Ebola could be the trigger for that. This is all on top of us, brothers and sisters. You know, the big brother nightmare is already old news. And so I ask you guys to pray also that, you know, this will get picked up because it needs to be put out. People need to know what we're dealing with, especially, you know, Christian people. We need to be sober. We need to be vigilant and we need to be serious. and know that our enemy is not, you know, the individual people who are Muslims. You know, the religion has, the jihadi religion and all that is evil, you know, to go kill people and all that. But the individuals are people that need to get saved. They need to become Christians and be filled with the love of God like any people in the world. You know, these are just people, and they're just puppets on a string being used by ultimately Satan and his minions, being the Illuminati, the CIA, the military industrial complex, and all this stuff. So I'm going to put this out. By the grace of God, I ask you guys to pray for me now that I'm back in the States, not in the Philippines anymore, that, you know, have the grace of God and protection. I ask you to pray for Alex Jones, too. You know, he puts his life at risk with all the things he says every day and the guests he has. God bless you guys. I love you guys. And let's stick together. Let's stick together as Christians and also as Americans, because as I mentioned in the video yesterday, the Declaration of Independence says we are endowed by our Creator with certain inalienable rights. In other words, we have rights given to us by God that we put on loan to a centralized representative republic government. So the government is under us, and we are under authority from God. And that is the true representative republic that we founded here, that our founding fathers founded. And we need to go back to that and maintain that. That's our only hope to survive as a country and survive as a Judeo-Christian peoples, is to come together in unity and the bond of peace and in love and stand together and, you know, let the Lord open our eyes. Who are the real enemies? You know, as the Bible says, we don't wrestle against flesh and blood, but against powers, principalities, and forces of darkness in high places. So our enemy is not those individuals in the Middle East, but those who are manipulating them and controlling them spiritually and financially, and all the things that the man has done, just like with Hitler. They financed Hitler. They financed Lenin. They financed Mao Zedong. Same people. Go look it up. I challenge you to go look it up. You will see that Big Daddy Warbucks, the Warburg brothers, they financed Lenin. The Germans put him in a locked train car with $10 million in gold and sent him back there. And they backed Mao Zedong too, these same people. They want to foment out of chaos a new world order. And the only thing standing between them and us is the American, Judeo-Christian, freedom-loving, liberty-loving sons of the Republic and daughters of the Republic. Let's stand together.